How should you resolve a conflict with someone? Good morning, everyone. This is our reflection question for today. A man in a hot air balloon realized he was lost. He reduced altitude and spotted a woman below. He descended a bit more and shouted, "Excuse me, can you help me? I promised a friend I would meet him an hour ago, but I don't know where I am." The woman below replied, "You're in a hot air balloon, hovering approximately 30 feet above the ground. You're between 40 and 41 degrees north latitude and between 59 and 60 degrees west longitude." "You must be an engineer," said the balloonist. "I am," replied the woman. "How did you know?" "Well," answered the balloonist, "everything you told me is technically correct, but I have no idea what to make of your information, and the fact is, I'm still lost. Frankly, you've not been much help at all. If anything, you've delayed my trip." The woman below responded, "You must be in management." "I am," replied the balloonist. "But how did you know?" "Well," said the woman, "you don't know where you are or where you're going. You have risen to where you are due to a large quantity of hot air. You made a promise which you've no idea how to keep, and you expect people beneath you to solve your problems. The fact is, you are in exactly the same position you were in before we met, but now somehow, it's my fault." In today's gospel reading, we reflect on Jesus' teaching on how to resolve conflicts, particularly with a brother or sister who has wronged us. Jesus has always taught us that He desires unity among us. He prayed this to His Father in heaven in the Last Supper, and He asked this not just once, but four times, to emphasize unity as primordial in a community of believers. He knows that conflicts will arise among us, and He advises us today that reconciliation should be our goal when disagreements become unwieldy. He wants us to strive for unity because this is essential to fulfill God's greatest commandment of love. When a brother or a sister has done something wrong, the first order of the day is to go to that person who has done us wrong to clarify, to try to understand what the cause of the conflict was, to seek forgiveness. Oftentimes, even if we feel the other person is the one that has wronged us, if we are to truly want peace and joy in our hearts, it takes a lot of courage to do it, and that is where God's grace is to be prayed for. Oftentimes, the fault lies not just in the person we are at loggerheads with. We too have a part to play. It takes two to tango, as they say. But when you are unable to resolve the conflict between the two of you alone, Jesus advises us to seek the help of a friend or two. Solutions sometimes come faster when we engage the help of another, as we may be too emotional to think of something better than finding fault and taking revenge. As they also say, two heads are better than one. In a renewal community setting, it could be your household or cell head, or in a parish, it could be the leader of your parish organization who is the best person to go to. If they are the ones we have a problem with, we go to the next level of leadership, perhaps their household head or the parish priest himself. When this effort to reconcile has also failed, only then should we resort to go to the church, that is the larger community, to seek help. And this assumes you are both a member of such. But prior to this, a posture of love, shown by gentleness and meekness, and an earnest desire to resolve and be reconciled, must dominate our hearts. It is never good to ventilate our side, our problems, our hurts against another, especially if tinged with anger, to the larger community if we have not even tried to seek the object of our problem and attempt to reconcile. The act of spreading the supposed fault of the other to all and sundry may lead us to sin, to gossip, to slandering and destroying the reputation of the other as we maintain our supposed innocence. It will only aggravate the situation, cause more harm, and is certainly not pleasing to God. The ego is at work here, and our pride will only be feasted by the devil to sow more harm than good. Jesus also teaches the power of praying together with one or two other persons to make that grace flow into us and the person we want to reconcile with, for Christ will be there in our midst. If the person continues to refuse the hand of peace, the ball is now in his court. He is now accountable to God. We have done our part. But We should not cease to pray that an attitude of love and understanding may continue to balloon in us so that the hot air of conflict will eventually dissipate in the atmosphere of God's grace. Let us pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, if ever I offended someone or someone has done me wrong, give me the opportunity to reconcile, feeding my heart with the grace of humility and love. This I pray in Jesus' holy and mighty name. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless your families, brothers and sisters. God bless our Catholic faith and couples for Christ.